Okay, FM, 101.7.
Na mama mi mwshi, na minko, osahini, bwachi, jan. Enchen, na yengwa chuchwe nkomo. Mbeka ya be 4 days in yeni, papa chuchwe nkomo. Nene, yebe tuwa nkomo so. Na mwmchwe FD no, na mwmfe mfia. Osahini, bwachi, jan. Be maba, mi mwachi. Osahini, bwachi, jan, mi mwachi.
Yeah, me use o.
Na kura mo to say.
Oh, ako kura me hoye.
Na uwa nkra na se uwa. Eyi.
No vie me, wo vie, wo vie, wo bia na ha.
Ah. Na won ye se. Ye se ya mechi wo. Mo
ka se mo, be official. Me wo me vile nyina me create commotion. Me a rattlesnake, me dem ratata, I don't boom.
You don't boom.
I don't boom, ratata.
Oh wow.
You can use it. You say Mr. Ratata.
We are Mr. Ratata.
Ratata.
Okay.
I know a sustained firing. Automatic.
Ratata to sustain.
Ratata.
Oh
my T bomb was running on to boom.
Boom.
Boom. Boom. Boom. Boom. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
Na anano ye no di nkomo no wo kan sem bia na wo se the way electoral commission no mo eye yade no they are walking us into civil war na nipa bi te said the national youth organizer of the New Patriotic Party eye nana bi akobo opposite for man ye se e be ya ye meche o te mi gram ye na me se mo fa ya be fa wa na.
No. They've come to interview me. When you invite me to Mark, I'm so. At the advantage of 70, you know, this is so respect. I can't travel without or medical grounds. I can't travel. But, and they have also understood it. They have sent somebody to come and talk to me. And there's no conspiracy here. I have not armed troops. We need Nigeria or have military people here. Now, I was given a cautionary warning. The ruling government said that the way I give men some name and a be no rookie be ex a and so much in the Hulu or ma. Come the assembly.
Oh, come back.
The next day, NDC, the largest opposition party in Ghana, has come out with a position which is defiant of what the government wants or a B wants or give men some wants. So, American. Now, it may rest there if people can come in and do something about it. But if it continue like this, it may lead to a conflict which will move away from peaceful resolution to armed resolution, which is civil war. That's American.
You are in a way inciting people.
Oh, I can understand them, but most of them have never been in the army or the police service. I can understand why.
They are all kind of. Sir, at the civil war, beba, yeah, no, mostly no, a bad family tradition at the Abba.
No. Civil war is a civil war because it involves everybody. That's why it's a civil war, it's not a military war. Oh, Namika said it has gone beyond the military involvement. If the civilian, even with stones, or conduct sit-ins and they put down their arms, that's the beginning of a civil war. Are you with me?
Me too, pa.
Now, in this Basusa, since you are Seba, in this civil war, but that's all I'm saying.
Now, Bakwana, me be sane say, I about 4 years, there be 4 years, be a cotto. The Bakwa won't tear see, I said, yeah, MBB for 1 year, 2012, no, I'm going to call Supreme Court, no.
Unfortunately, my jammy constitution was a crack. You go and take your constitution and look at it. I think it's Article 64 or some such thing. Oh, one more thing. There will be one of a registered voters' record data, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that should be updated with amendment from time to time. And the position is very clear that after 4 years, even 1 year, you know, some people have died who are on the list. Whose name need to be cleaned out of it. Some people have and come of age, who should be also entered into the list. So that may come. And that does not amount to an overhaul of the existing constitution. It amounts to its amendment, delete and insert. What has to come in? Born American. You don't vote money, go to parliament and vote money and waste time, you know, and resources to ask for the constitution, the registration record to be done again. And that's my beef. That if they have the Mensa have repeated and said you're choosing the words carefully, that it should be amended. The constitution will be amended to add those who have been excluded, who are eligible to vote. That's the, you cannot disenfranchise a Ghanaian. This is a Ghanaian, he's a Ghanaian. That's also fair enough. Baruka said, may that advantage me go queue in the Asan to go and register. I won't go.
And
I'm sure a lot of people are in my position to do that because my name is there. If they are not being lazy politically and electorally, Jay Mensah is not being lazy. Her job is this should be done on daily basis.
But I say, what year, ma'am, in the electoral commission for? One, the machines are obsolete. Two, your search chair regions in Mukra Bobia. Three, machine Ukra, Yeni Yankasian data, no, and one Yamabebe was a lead company, no, and he as a sovereign state, you know, and Yamabuwa, Yam password in Yamabe as our four.
What you're saying, I don't want to preempt you, is that the constitution needs cleaning up, which I don't oppose. If we have identified the problem, it's bloated, machines in year, we should correct the mistakes and put the things right. But you do not invite me at 76 to go and re-register. I won't go. Tell them clearly. Say, and there are so many people in my position who would do that. They should. It's a daily basis affair. It's a commission. It's a commission. We should have an operations room to receive data from BDF and BDF sources, family forces, so many forces, migration office, new people coming in, visitors coming in, and take steps to. Let me tell you a story. When I went to Britain, after 2 weeks, I received a letter from equivalent of electoral commission there. Say, they have information that I was living in addresses, so, with seven people. Four of us are of age to vote. But your name is not on the register. So these are the details of the seven of us. I must confirm whether the details are correct for them to insert it in the register. And I did it, and I sent it to them. The next election day, I went, and my name was there, and I voted. Period. Why can't they do that here? Why are we paying them? They should have an operations room that will keep constant on daily basis updating some of this data. And now, American. It's part of where you are paid to do that. So, we are not going to allow them to waste our money and resources and time to do something to assist this government to rig this election. Now, if they there will be civil war because there are interests which you don't agree with them. You know. They are available to them is stones. The whole stones are organized sit-in. That's the beginning of a civil war. I believe in what I'm saying. I have committed no crime. I've not broken any rules. I'm saying that if you do this, expect this consequence. Now, if you either you like it or you have plans to do it, When I was managing an armed anger in this country, he has got no experience. He's a rookie. I'll learn how to walk. He must learn to how to walk properly. Otherwise, when he falls down, he'll be dead.
Power be power.
I didn't power. There's no power that they have that is bigger than my power in 1979.
And almost a whole power, me.
You can't come and tell me at his age I was running the country, not running a youth organization of some bogus party.
Ah, over party be bogus.
And then what? If they allow somebody like that to slip through to be the youth organizer, it can only be a bogus party.
Oh. Why am I bound to you?
Recklessly, they should hold him to account because we're creating problem for them. He is the problem, not me.
Who is
he to organize? I should be arrested. Who is he?
Awaya, national youth organizer and a lawyer by
what
profession.
Youth organizer? Mister, me youth organizer. Me ma kura kura. I care no. But he should learn how to respect old age and knowledge. Oh, it shows there's a sign of disrespect.
But now,
no, Daddy, why is your mom? Because you would know when you are.
So now, but I, oh no,
yeah, forgive him.
No, I on point of law, say the old kind, you know, amounts to treasonable comments. I bet immediately you now, but our mind, but it's yes, sir. So, on point of law, no, and then I'll catch a positive for say, one more than I can do.
Oh, no, woman, now I committed crime.
To
ask somebody to be arrested for not committing any crime, it's in itself a crime in itself. He has no mandate to ask anybody to arrest me. Let's make that absolutely clear. Akufo-Addo has no right to ask anybody to arrest me. The police will advise him that they are my enemy. The appropriate agency says he has a normal abyssal permission or my permission. But he can't just sit down and say, go ahead, arrest him. Who does it? You are not in the Sun Republic, Banana Republic.
Hey, now remember, and now you're 15th May 1979. And Saad Breno, Mampenida Da Rollins, Kawoko Yokua, Anya Ye. Me say, and now you're 15th May. Hello.
Hold it. Hey, Kaji. If you don't go, I'll show you today. Get out of there. Yes, I said, go out of there. Hey, throw him out. Go and sit in your room. Throw him out. But I know you're in here. Me, from the interview, you know what we're now.
Mego.
Okay. Hello.
Ah, let me be sir. 15th May 1979. And then see 15th May. And then I will carry on my bakosem.
What I was saying is that we have got a new democracy. We have got a new democracy. Eh? When in 1982, April 5th, 1982, I launched Campaign for Democracy in Africa Center in London. Nanado was on the table with me. We have come a long way in nurturing the democracy. So people like Nanabi should be contained. They should be restrained, you know, from making that reckless statement. Because I have committed no conspiracy to be arrested. He's not an IGP. He's not, if you're a youth officer, you are not a police officer. On Americano. So he can only advise his superior. Somebody would say that it's an estimate of almost estimate is that if the election was to be held tomorrow, he will win by hooping 500 margin. So where do they get information from? They're assuming, without admitting, crossing the tour, it's information that is restricted. The party must be restricted by that's why it's classified information. It's secret, confidential, and all that. Not everybody who living within the party have access to that. So they should not come and start harassing us with something that you don't have a basis for. They should restrain people like Nana B, it's a rookie. He doesn't understand what the game plan is. So they are the ones who, I mean, the game mentioned, they are the ones who are creating, walking us into gambling. As our life into drought and possible civil war. That's why I'm saying a conditional. That if they don't restrain their man, it can lead to a civil war because significantly, after I have spoken, the largest political opposition party in Ghana, NDC, has come forward to echo my position. You know, So if you insist in doing that, they take to the bush and take the fight now. What is it that, what does it mean? Civil war. And I told you so. So they will either have to sit again and restrain people like Nanadi, who is a rookie in the game, and he must be told point blank that there are some of us who have done this long before he was born. All American. The German side is an appointee, or yet a commander in chief. Like I said, nobody can compare him. A force can compare her to change your ways. If there's no government for you to respond to her,
he has come of age, or a lawyer. It was said
he can be a governor general, he can be attorney general, but he's talking bullshit, he's talking nonsense. If you're a lawyer, you cannot order somebody to be arrested just because you are a lawyer.
Was it because
you have to go through the legal process on Americano and come to the conclusion that he deserves the let the judiciary decide that? You don't decide that. The bogus lawyer who can do that, you know.
I see, General.
Yes.
South 15th May. No. Sabre no anopano. Then I would say, what is a koyoku?
Now it's a you can. We are going past the 15-year rule. 15-year rule. I can talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
A week before 15 May, he called me to now tune it to say in Accra and told me that. It's a time for us to move. Remember, I was organizing the Free Africa Movement, movement in the armed forces, you know, current affairs, cover plan. And I told him, point blank, hey, Charlie, you are a flying officer, I am a captain, you can't run this country on that rank. You see, take it easy. You know, within the shortest possible time, some of us will be upgraded to run companies and stuff like that. So we can then control the situation in Ghana's direction. Very nice. That I warn him that if he wants to do it, he'll become a cannon fodder. He never became a cannon fodder, but out of consideration, I thought I was the best man at his wedding.
When are you the best man?
Oh yes, ask. You don't like what issue that I was best man at his wedding.
Now I worry. Are you?
Nana Kunadu.
I start you.
Because I was in lower six there when they were in Kumpo, so I knew them.
Okay. Now, no. Sabla no. Was what person who could do your mind so. I don't know about a man for man, yes, my quade, and I'm off. I see, say, no, press for
you. Oh, you see, by the nature of a coup, no, you can't go and broadcast it. Go on, Americano. Even within friends, you go to the very circumstance who you talk to, otherwise, they will come and arrest you. They are not a paid informant, you may not know. The fear people have for me is that I waded through all that and succeeded. In making a successful counter coup in Ghana. There's a difference between a coup that directed against a sitting elected government and a coup against an illegal military government. It's a different issue. The other one is arm versus arm. The other one, with another. Then you rumble, come to the broadcasting house and say, yeah, my genius, this is what I'm speaking about. When the man says, there's no fight in that. But in our case, 27 hours. Well, that's the only thing came to say that, he has to attend. So we also responded. And for 27 hours, there was a firefight. Oh, that's proper war. As one of my favorite broadcasters, lady, Akuya would say, I say, we're facing war now, the police baton.
I see. Now, Ayadena, who call you, no? A June phone.
Okay.
Ayadena, how call you June phone?
Oh, some are catch, though. On one, he must have end work for 15 minutes a chain. And you're due to be executed Monday morning, June 4. We have an advanced organized group in the armed forces, junior officers and junior ranks. So I activated the movement and we went in and told him and former government now who was serious. He did it, we told it.
Eji Senka, why don't you do for now and then on your crack as a
former by now? He knows it.
Now, you know, Obiri Buahi, you Deputy General Secretary.
Okay.
Or say, and you're not trying to command pay. Was all the boy who suffered in Anna, you for no one are we here cool in the idea was all boah. Now, we know the idea, now crown one will be a number faster. Best post person, Keke.
Nonsense. Oh, no, I mean. That's a reported thing. I'll say nothing about reported thing. That is his opinion. He said that is his opinion.
I see.
He's entitled to his thing, but it's not true. The story has not been told yet. Though I've given snippets of it in my book, Call to Duty, The Enforced Restoration of Constitution 1979. Go and get one and read.
Okay, Marty. Osa yine ni mami nyawo eneja ehwe eyi omanfo a enso aba nche why?
Wola no kati ondi.
Me se wada o mami nyawo ne hwe omanfo aba nche.
Yo. I had a zenye easy kra before be matter.
Yes.
What business why? Madam must why?
Yes, yeah, that's bye.
Yo.
Osa yine bo achi jani ene ne twetwe enkom no key 101.7 suni. Na ye nkwai.
Okay, FM. Okay. 101.7.